Hello students, warm wishes to one and all. Hope you are all very well. I think you have watched, enjoyed and got an idea about our previous video prepositions, which is very essential to know very well. Today we are going to learn about the poem Give Me Strength, written by one of our famous Indian poets, Rabindranath Tagore. Before we go into the poem, we know about the poet. They have given the details related to poet also, about the poet. Rabindranath Tagore, 7th May 1861 to 7th August 1941. Usually called Gurudev, was a learned man from West Bengal, from the Indian subcontinent. He was a poet, musician and artist. He reshaped Bengali literature and music. He is the author of the Gitanjali, which is a collection of beautiful verse. He was the first Indian to win the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1930. Tagore's poetry is viewed as spiritual and patriotic. He was referred to as the Bard of Bengal. See children, here birth details and death details were also given. Date of birth and date of death were mentioned here, and he is also known as Gurudev, means a learned person, very respectable person. And he is from West Bengal, from the Indian subcontinent. He was a poet, musician and artist. He is versatile. What is meant by versatile? Well talented. He reshaped, means brought the good shape or made it in a different way. What did he do? He has reshaped Bengali literature and music. He has written the work in a different way. And he is the author of Gitanjali, very famous book children. And it is the collection of beautiful verse. Verse means written in short lines with a regular rhythm. So this is followed at the time of writing poetry. And we have to feel very proud, he is the first Indian to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. So every writer dreams to win the Nobel Prize. He was fulfilled in that aspect. He is very spiritual and patriotic, means he follows all the beliefs and at the same time he loves the country. He was referred as the Bard of Bengal. Bard means poet. This is a very simple poem children, very short poem also, but it makes us to think a lot. We have to understand the inner meaning of the poem. So give me strength. What is the reason? For what purpose poet needs strength? Whom he is asking to give strength? And in which way he has asked strength? Let us see. This is my prayer to thee, my Lord, strike. Strike at the root of penury in my heart. Give me the strength lightly to bear my joys and sorrows. Give me the strength to make love fruitful in service. Give me the strength never to disown the poor or bend my knees before insolent might. Give me the strength to raise my mind high above daily trifles. And give me the strength to surrender my strength to thy will with love. See here children, this is my prayer to thee, my Lord, strike. Thee in the sense, in poetic language, thee means you. Strike means hit forcibly. Directly I am speaking with you only, my Lord. Oh God, I am speaking with you. What is he speaking? Strike at the root of penury in my heart. Penury means extreme poverty. So please hit forcibly. So please eradicate this poverty. It should not be there at all in my heart. I should not feel sad at any moment. Give me the strength lightly to bear my joys and sorrows. So give me the strength. For which reason he needs strength here, children? He has to bear, means he is able, he should be able to enjoy his happiness. At the same time, he should be able to feel the sadness. And how should he overcome from that sorrowness or sadness? Give me strength in all these aspects. I should be able to overcome these all. Give me the strength to make my love fruitful in service. Fruitful means producing results. So I should be service oriented. I should help others in a selfless way, and it should give good results. Give me the strength never to disown the poor, means never to refuse the people who has come or who is in a bad condition. I should help them at any cost, or bend my knees before insolent might. Insolent means what, children? Extremely unpleasant. So don't make me to bend my knees before unpleasant things, or don't make me to feel bad, or don't make me to face disrespectful situations. I should lead the life in a respectable way, in an honorable way. I should be in a position to help others. I should be in a position to lead the life in a peaceful way. Give me the strength to rise my mind high above daily trifles. See, children, trifles means things of little value or importance. Let us see or think about ourselves only. For very silly things or minute things, we become very bad and sad, and we spoil our day also. Not only day, sometimes life also. So here, what is he asking? So he is praying to God, please give me energy not to bother about simple things which are not essential or unnecessary. I should be able to balance each and everything. I should lead my life in a peaceful way. And give me the strength to surrender my strength to thy will with love. So what is he asking? I should utilize my strength in a better way. And I should be able to give love to others. So if you understand, this is a prayer of Rabindranath Tagore. He is praying the God to give each and everything what he needs. So see, children, it is one of the inspiring poems. And moreover, this poem is written in the form of a prayer. The poet asks the Lord to grant him power so that he will be able to conquer all the hurdles, means all the difficulties in his life. And he always bow down before the will of God. I should be very polite in front of you. Even though I am very happy, I should not feel proud about myself. This is a very short and beautiful poem, children. The poet prays to God from the core of his heart and remove the ignorance from there. See, children, recite the poem. Try to understand the inner meaning of the poem. And they have given the meanings of the hard words also, glossary. Learn these also. And at the same time, after getting an idea about this poem, refer the question answers. Answers of these questions were given in your material already. And choose the right option and write it in the brackets given. Multiple choice questions, children, try to answer these also. And then checkpoint. It helps you to know the levels of understanding related to the poem. And see here, degrees of comparison. This is there in your material, children. Already we have learnt about this in your previous lessons also. And now it is the time to test your knowledge. Answer these questions in your material only with pencil. Change the degrees of comparison in the following sentences as directed. Try once, children. Try to answer these. Thank you.